Everybody, welcome back to Simtech in the G1000 simulator. Today we're going to go over how to brief an FAA approach plate. Check out our videos on aviator.nyc for how to load an approach in the G1000 and how to verify all the points are correct in the G1000 altitudes, headings, and we've also already gone over notes in that video. Starting from the top here on the EFB, for flight in this case will give us a red flag here if there are any NOTAMs that are applicable to this approach. Now, of course, we've checked the NOTAMs pre-flight, but if we did miss something, it's just one last chance to catch it. And then moving down to make sure we're looking at the correct chart, we've got the dates there, the effective date, 16th of July 20 through 13th of August 20. It's the 17th of July now, so we're in the correct date range. And now the procedure title, RNAV GPS-19 in Republic. I'll compare that to what I've got in my FMS, which agrees. Farmingdale RNAV GPS-19 says LPV. Those are the minimums we're flying to. And the final approach course here of 193, 192 checks in the FMS. And we're gonna fly over Maury if we're on the glide slope and check that we're at 1500 feet against the glide slope, which checks in the FMS as well, and then continue down to our LPV category B minima of 348 feet and 1 mile of visibility. I'll bring up my reference information here. On the PFD, you can see 350 is set. That's the closest I can get to being at, but above 348 for the approach minima. Moving on from there, touchdown zone elevation of 81 feet. The only approach lighting we have on this are reels, runway end identifier lights. So the touchdown zone elevation is not particularly important to this approach, but if we were doing an ILS, say with an approach lighting system, if we did have those approach lights in sight, we could go down to 100 feet above touchdown zone elevation. So touchdown zone elevation is could be an important piece of information. Not so much on this approach, but from there, if we don't have that mile of visibility as we come down the approach to 348 feet, we're gonna go mist, which is gonna be for this aircraft. Mixture and props verify that they're forward throttle, max allowable, and pushing the toga button as we push those throttles up. Flaps to, in the case of this airplane, all the way up, and with a positive rate of climb, gear up, and then open the cowl flaps as required and select our navigation source as we climb out following the missed approach procedure, which is runway heading to 2,000 feet, and then making a left climbing turn to 3000 direct Deer Park, and then the hold, which we've already reviewed on a separate video already, but just to make sure, 200 is the inbound and 4 mile legs checks. And then in the very unlikely event that we actually do make a landing on our airport diagram here, we'll look at making our turn off to the right, most likely at Bravo 3 or Bravo 4, and going to, say, Republic Jet Center North, for instance. So that's how I'd go through a briefing of an FAA approach plate. We hope you learned something from this, and if you did, please like and subscribe.